Recently, I decided to go through a 90-day fitness journey for myself and my health alone. Unlike what most people say about having a specific goal, I chose to have no numerical goal and focused on committing to living a sustainable, healthier lifestyle instead, as I saw numerical and visual progress with my body along the way. After the first 30 days, I was able to round up 13 health and fitness tips for you, so please do not fast forward because the details are very important so you won't relapse or get injured so easily. And I promise you will realize that you don't have to go through fad diets and crazy cardio exercises to get fit. But before I begin, I would like to say some disclaimers and reminders. 1. I understand that I am not overweight. But before this started, I personally and honestly felt heavy, unproductive, and sick that I wanted to get up, be healthy, and get fit. So again, my goal is to be stronger, eat healthier, to feel better, and it's not just about my physical appearance.
2. I am a client under Coach Mac from Kinetic or PH for my workouts, and Coach Tim, which is Tim Nutrition, for my diet. Therefore, my tips and my journey are guided and approved by these experts and not me alone.
I've also been a trained dancer and had physical therapy with strength and conditioning after, so I'm already familiar with the proper forms.
3. This video will only show my month-long and hopefully sustainable journey, so don't expect any extreme results or changes.
There are no crash diets and crazy restrictions whatsoever because I want to look at this as a long-term practice. I will also continue and upload more episodes in the future, and hey, slow progress is still progress.
4. This video is not meant to body shame anyone.
I am totally for body positivity, but that doesn't mean that health and fitness should be neglected as well. I am not encouraging you to feel bad about your body, as this video was just created to motivate me as other people are watching, but also here's a video for those who wish to physically or even emotionally and mentally feel better.
5. Our body types may differ, and that's okay.
I have an 8-hourglass body type, so if you have a different body type based on your genes, the difference between my waist and my butt will differ from yours. And I also initially lose weight quickly, but I hit a plateau once my weight is back to normal, which is 111 pounds on an average.
Hence, your timetable and results can completely differ from mine, so do not be discouraged if yours end up turning out differently. Lastly, my 90-day journey will be uploaded around August, so this video will only show my 30-day results and of course the 13 tips. Speaking of results, unfortunately, I've been measuring my body fat wrong this entire time. So I didn't think that my age mattered as long as my height was correct. So for this whole 30-day experience, my age was 11 years old when I'm supposed to be 21. So that completely spiked up my body fat percentage to 27.2%. But I do know that last November 2019, when I visited my nutritionist, my body fat percentage was at 26.9%. And now, after 6 months of consistently working out, and also this 30-day challenge of working out and also eating healthy at the same time, from 26.9% last November, I have lowered down on this 30th day to 22.2% body fat. A reason why I wanted to keep track of my body fat percentage was because I do know that muscle mass is heavier than body fat. So you can end up weighing much heavier, but it's actually like filled with muscles. So you're on the stronger side than, you know, the body fat side, which is completely healthier. That's why I really wanted to focus on that. But for the other measurements, when I started out this journey, last April 30, I was at 113.2 pounds with 27 inches waistline and 35 butt or glutes. After 30 days, I'm now at 110.8 pounds and also 24.75 inches waistline, but still 35 inches butt. So that's completely okay and good because it means that I lost fat, yet I still gained muscle. Now I know my weight difference is not as big, but now you can see that muscle mass really is heavier than body fat. Because even if I lost only around over 2 pounds, I still lost a lot of fat around my waist. And that's like the biggest indicator that I could have. And also now that my body fat percentage is 22.2%, that's like a huge difference. And that's something that I'm really proud of. So I know my results aren't as huge as the ones you've seen online, like losing so much weight in like 2 weeks or a month. But the thing is, I really wanted this to be sustainable and long term. So from then on, I kind of understood that, okay, this will really take a while and that's okay because I want it to be sustainable and I don't want it just to be like a crash diet or whatsoever. And this transformation photo is only the first 30 days and I have 60 days to go. Now let's begin with the 13 tips that helped me, as it will now help you. What is this?
1. The most obvious, exercise. As for me, I initially exercised for strength due to an injury, but Coach Carl and ACEC PT very recently made me realize that strength was necessary to lose more weight and not just endlessly doing cardio. How? You must mix it up with strengthening exercises to increase your muscle mass. And no, you won't necessarily get bulky. Instead, you will actually burn more calories and decrease fat levels because of having more muscle mass. I will explain how this works on the 12th tip, so stay put. P.S. It involves resting. Anyway, you can work out through YouTube, an online dance class, jogging in place, or indoor cycling if you have a bike. As you can see, I don't. Just pick a workout that you enjoy where your body can move around and sweat. But to have better results, get an online coach. Mine's Coach Mac from Kinetocar PH, so he makes my personalized programs and watches me to check my form, which is very important to get results without getting injured.
But if you want to follow a free YouTube video like I sometimes have, my good friend Nina Alvia, who's also a sports science graduate from UP Diliman, recommends Sohee Fit, Athlene X, Mad Fit, and Victoria Grimes. Personally, the one that I follow is Mad Fit on YouTube, and then I also follow Sohee Fit on Instagram to educate myself. And sometimes I also try checking out Athlene X's video on YouTube. And also, to be honest, I haven't really checked out Victoria Grimes, but you know, I trust my friend, and so I trust who she recommends to. And unfortunately, if you're waiting for me to say names that are famous on YouTube, like as fitness gurus or fitness YouTubers, well, you might want to research on them first because a lot of them are actually not as credible as you think. Like, they look good, but the stuff they say, I don't know. Like, okay, I'm not like completely knowledgeable about that, but I did some research and there's a lot of misinformation, so do your research too.
2. Have fitness buddies and establish your routine. I have my Kinetocar buddies in which we work out around 3 to 4 times a week at 7 a.m.
Yeah, I know it's early, but I had to compromise.
And my high school buddy in which we work out around 5 times a week at 4 or 5 p.m. This way, it made it easier for me to stay consistent and motivated because I'm doing it with other people and the routine has already been set. Plus, posting on Instagram has also helped me stay motivated as I knew that other people were watching. 3. Check your progress. I don't know about you, but it helps me stay committed and motivated once I see results. I check mine almost every day, and this is not an obsession, but rather for the sake of accountability. I will know what habits and foods to keep and which to disregard, but honestly, once or twice a week will do. So yes, it's normal to feel really good and really bad about yourself every once in a while. I check my progress with a weighing scale that also measures the body fat percentage, which by the way is way harder and longer to lose. I got mine from my nutritionist, and just message him on Instagram if you want one. Then I also check my waist and the biggest part of my butt, yes, butt, aka my glutes, with a measuring tape. The smaller the waist, the better. But only if the butt measurement stays the same, to indicate that you're working out enough and not losing muscle. For the body fat percentage, the manual says that it's best to measure before dinner as you are not dehydrated. Hence, the fat percentage won't spike up. But for the weight and measurements, my coaches say that it's best to measure the moment after you pee after waking up. 4. For women, note your menstrual cycle. All I want to say is work around it. Do not force yourself to work out while you're having dysmenorrhea or when you feel tired, because your body needs the most rest while you're on your period. Embrace it, eat what your body needs, and let yourself rest. As posted in Healthline.com, according to Christopher Holigsworth, the period is a complex time from a hormonal standpoint. Both progesterone and estrogen are at their lowest during the entire length of the period phase of the menstrual cycle, which can make people feel tired and less energetic. But if you really want to work out, Healthline.com says that you can do light cardio, low volume strengthening, and yoga since there are still benefits when you work out on your period anyway. 5. Do not work out every day.
Sounds so good to be true? Well, it is true. You need to rest to keep it sustainable and long term so you don't end up quitting. Also, it's very important for your body to rest so it can repair and grow its muscles. Listen to your body when it's telling you to rest, and don't worry because based on my personal experience and credible sources, it's really 80% diet and 20% workout. I'm not kidding.
Don't overwork yourself. As for me, I work out around 4 or 5 times a week. Then if I really want to move around on the 6th day, I just stretch a little, but that's it. Brings me to my next tip. 6. Eat and eat your proteins. No, I do not mean keto diet. I just mean that one needs enough proteins and even unsaturated or healthy fats and carbs to repair the muscles and to see results. If you want to be healthy, it's more than just drastically losing weight and fat. Don't be too restricting with food and make things practical and realistic to keep it sustainable or long term.
Carbs, fat, and protein does not make you fat, but being on a caloric surplus does, especially when you're not moving around.
So, should you be in a calorie deficit then? 7. Yes, decrease your caloric intake. So count them. I have a personal nutritionist, so my nutrient portions and calorie deficit is prescribed by him as an expert.
So I will not be sharing my ideal daily calorie count, not because I'm being selfish, but simply because your body type and lifestyle may be completely different from mine. Plus, there are also days where I had no self-control and exceeded my calorie count, as you can tell from the other clips.
However, I do understand that not everyone has the budget to have a personal nutritionist, so you may use MyFitnessPal, the application, which is not sponsored. I use it to count my calories and stay aware of my nutrient portions, whether I had enough protein for my muscles or too much carbs and calories for the day.
I wouldn't claim that it's 100% accurate, but it helps me figure out which foods are high and low in calories, protein, carbohydrates, and fats. And so when I realized that this certain food has too much calories in it and it's not making me full, I get to avoid it the next time.
To help you out, 8. Stop eating once you're full. It gets easier when you're more conscious about it. Sometimes we keep eating when we're just thirsty or unconsciously taking in food because it's good. Be aware of how your stomach is while you're eating, and honestly, it changed my portions by a lot. Drink lots of water too. Water, not soda, just water. Or you can also drink hot green tea or lemon water. Those are fine too. As for snacks, 9. Snack less or eat healthy. Snacking is a problem for a lot of people, including me. I love snacking with chips, cereal, and I love eating instant noodles when I watch K-drama. But I honestly felt terrible and sick after. All you have to do is portion them. For me, I try to not exceed more than 1 fist of unhealthy snacks in a day. Example, if it's a cinnamon bun, I only eat half and save the other half for the next day. If it's fruits or other healthy snacks, I don't limit myself with the amount anymore. I just make sure that I'm conscious once I'm full and that I still have calories allotted for dinner. In other words, 10. Enjoy what you eat. As long as you know that nutrients plus treats equals sustainability. It's much harder to resist junk and have a clean diet while on lockdown, especially if your family ended up buying tons of chips and instant noodles for storage.
Plus, I completely get it. We all have our cravings. And guess what? Let yourself satisfy those cravings and don't deprive yourself too much. But take note, portion them out.
Have a little so you don't end up binging and giving up from deprivation. It doesn't always have to be a salad or a healthy smoothie. As long as you stick to your calories and eat more nutritious food for the rest of the day or week, then it's fine. It's human nature.
If you exceed calories in a certain day, then compensate the day right after and not the next month.
To keep it consistent, 11. Find the right diet plan for you. Keto, vegan, intermittent fasting, caloric deficit, and many others.
Unfortunately, there's no diet that works for everyone. Works as in sustain and works as in results.
Sometimes it works for you until you hit a plateau, then it'll be time to change things up.
I tried keto diet before, but it stopped working for me after 1 week. And I also tried intermittent fasting, but it just didn't work out for me and my lifestyle, simply because I get hungry so fast. I also have an acidic stomach. And I had school that time, so it was harder to maintain. I know that these diets have sustainably worked for other people, but that's not the case for me, and that's okay.
Hence, as prescribed by my nutritionist, I stuck with having a calorie deficit where I space out my meals and have way smaller portions so I can eat more throughout the day, appropriate for my lifestyle. Again, find the right long-term diet for you. 12. Sleep well.
I know some of you will automatically go like, oh, okay, that's not for me, I'm gonna skip this tip, but hear me out first.
I've been feeling like crap for the past 2 weeks because I feel like my self-control has been really bad when it comes to my diet. Like, even if I'm working out, I'm not really seeing any results. And then, I don't know, like yesterday, I just felt so tired for some reason. I didn't work out. I just, you know, I let myself rest. I let myself sleep in. I didn't alarm or whatever.
I only knew about this after my 30-day journey, but I did notice that my results looked better and I was less bloated the next day each time I got a good amount of sleep. But I never really wondered why. This was until I came across Coach Carl's post educating the public about how we burn the most calories when we rest and much less when we work out. However, workouts are still important because in order to have a high basal metabolic rate, we need more muscle mass to repair, which obviously comes from your training. So again, don't just do cardio, but do strengthening exercises too. 13. You're human too.
It's definitely normal and okay to have a relapse, as long as you get back on track as soon as you're conscious about it. If you end up overeating, don't restart the next day or the next week or the next month. Restart right away on your next meal. If you intake too many calories in one day, then compensate the day after by eating less and maybe having a workout. If you don't feel like working out, then don't work out, but try not to exceed over 3 days of not working out or at least moving around.
Getting sustainably fit is not a quick and easy process. If it were, then everyone would have done it by now. It does not take only a 2-week fitness YouTuber program to see sustainable results. It will take months and a few relapses before you get used to the practices that come along with being fit and healthy. And also, whenever you feel lazy or demotivated, always remember that today's efforts are tomorrow's results.
If you reached this point, thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate it. Again, all of these tips in my journey are approved and guided by experts and not me alone. So you can consider this as credible tips. If you're trying to be healthier like me, good luck and let's do it together. And also, I can't wait to show you guys my 90-day journey. It's going well so far. It's not perfect, but it's going well. Follow my Instagram, SusDTan, for more updates. And also, don't forget to like this video if you haven't yet and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell if you want to. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!